All right, we have to talk about this morning. The South Carolina state trooper is facing serious charges, potentially up to 20 years in prison, after he shot this unarmed man during a traffic stop for an alleged seatbelt violation. The whole thing was caught on this police officer's his patrol car dash cam. So just we'll play it for you, but just a heads up to you at home. This is maybe tough for you to watch, but I can tell you at the end, Jones survived the shooting. Take a look.
Can I see your license, please?
Get on the ground!
I just got my license. You think you're my license? I grabbed the license right here. That's my license right there.
Put your hands behind your back. 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 Put your hands behind your back.
What did I do, sir?
Are you hit?
I think so. I can't feel my leg. I don't know what happened. I just grabbed my leg.
Rachel on A66, I need a 1052.
Why did you shoot me?
Well, you dove head first back into your car.
I'm sorry.
Why did you shoot me? I'm sorry. Okay, so the officer has been fired. Let me get that out there. And he has been charged with aggravated assault and battery. But let's have a big discussion about this. Mo Ivory, radio host and attorney, joins me. And also Paul Callen, CNN legal analyst and former New York City homicide prosecutor. So welcome to both of you. And I mean, just I've seen it a few times now. It sort of makes you sick to the stomach to watch. But I just want to begin with your visceral reactions to this piece of video. Mo, first to you.
You know, I wasn't really surprised when I saw it. And I'm Brooke, not actually even shocked, because I don't think this is the first time that we've seen graphic video of an officer shooting a suspect. I mean, what I'm so happy about was that there was the video and there was swift movement. We've seen these kind of videos before, but what we haven't seen is swift movement towards doing something to these officers that are obviously using excessive force. So what I was pleased about was that we're telling this story and we're finally seeing some action against a police officer. But this is obviously not an isolated incident or something that we know isn't going on in the street every day.
Just another example, as we talked, especially in the wake of what happened in Ferguson, the need for body cameras, the need for these patrol cameras, these dash cams, which we'll get to in a minute. But Paul Callen, too, just your response watching it.
It was one of the most shocking videos I've ever seen of police misconduct.
Really?
Well, it is, because he's firing directly into the chest of this innocent victim, who, by the way, was just obeying the officer's order to go for his license. It's almost like the officer's on autopilot. Just once he pulls the trigger the first time, he can't stop himself. So it's just a really very disturbing film. And obviously, South Carolina authorities handled it properly. They moved quickly, unlike Ferguson, by the way, where things have stalled, I think, and the public has become upset about the case.
So staying with you, though, and that's pretty stunning, I think, just to hear you in all your years saying this is one of the worst pieces of video you've seen. We know that this officer has been charged with aggravated assault and battery, carries up to 20 years in prison. You know, his boss has come forward, said obviously he didn't follow protocol. There wasn't the threat that he had perceived had existed. Yet you said to me right before the segment started, there is no slam dunk in criminal law.
No, there isn't. And I'll give you an example of it. The last time I saw a tape that was, it wasn't as bad as this, but it's right up there, is the famous Rodney King case. Remember, he was stopped in California, surrounded by police officers, clubbed him, kicked him, beat him. That case went to trial before a California jury, and no convictions in the case by a state jury, despite the compelling nature of that video. Mm-hmm. Later on, there were convictions in a subsequent federal case. So you don't know what's going to happen in a courtroom when a case gets tried. But I'd have to say, I would be very surprised if this case doesn't result in a conviction.
Okay. Mo, you say you weren't necessarily surprised by it. Of course, we've watched multiple incidents of you know, young men being shot, unarmed men being shot, and a lot of times killed. Fortunately for this man, he was treated and released from the hospital. But it just is another example of, I don't know if it's lack of training among police officers, which we talked about so much in the wake of Ferguson, or also the fact that, you know, this is one example where there happened to be a dash cam, you know, camera rolling.
Right, and a dash cam rolling, and also not the cell phones of people who are sort of just in the area, which always seems to discredit when, you know, when it starts to cycle in, the story begins to cycle. But I was shocked to hear Paul say that that's one of the most shocking videos. To me, no more shocking than Eric Garner being choked out by police officers in the middle of the street while he was begging for his life. I mean, I think we've seen plenty of examples of these kind of videos, whoever was taking the video, to know that we have a serious problem. But what I, and you are right, we don't know what is, Paul, we don't know what is going to happen to this officer once the trial starts. But what I was pleased to see was that he was immediately fired, because many times officers aren't even fired, even when they are arrested and they go to jail. They're still paid on administrative leave. So I was really pleased to see that he was fired and that he will go to trial.
Well, you know,
but again,
police officers, like suspects in other criminal cases, have due process rights as well. And what happens is you get an arrest. Well, you have an arrest quickly when you have compelling, clear evidence. Now, you cited that chokehold case. That's still under investigation in New York.
Right, and the officer has not been arrested.
There was no video camera in that. There was a cell phone video
but
that only showed part of the incident.
It's
so
an issue
look
of
at
force.
It again.
It's an issue of force, and I understand, Mo, where you're getting
autopsy.
At, but it is different. It is different. And let me just point out before we wrap this.
There's an autopsy showing that he was chokehold, and the chokehold was the reason for his death.
We were talking about video of an
incident.
Not
I understand your point. I understand your point loud and clear. And again, we'll be watching to see what happens with this officer. I mean, here he was fired, potentially could face 20 years in prison, and this is also someone who received a Medal of Valor in 2012 from the state of South Carolina. It's just incredible how one incident can change really the rest of your life for not just him, but the victim here as well. Mo Ivory, thank you very much. Paul Callen, thank you.
Thank you.